Like many Americans, once 9/11 hit, I felt a strong need to do something about it. I was angry and upset that our country had been attacked, and I thought maybe it's time for me to look into joining the military. My grandfather was a veteran of World War I, and my father was a veteran of the United States Air Force. I try to give as much back as I can. I think I owe something because I've been fortunate. I had, at the time, a lot of legal experience. I was serving as state's attorney in Frederick County at the time I joined the JAG Corps. They accepted me and I was able to go, and probably 2 or 3 weeks later I was off in boot basic training. During the first mobilization with the Trial Defense Service, I was representing soldiers that got in trouble. The second time I was on a task force that was created to design the military's response if the H1N1 situation had turned into an epidemic. So I spent 90 days also at Fort Meade, and I left for Afghanistan back in October of 2018. It was the greatest, worst experience of my life, for sure. It was a very dangerous area, carrying very heavy equipment every time I went outside the forward operating base where I was assigned. From time to time when I'd be traveling, things would happen that certainly got my adrenaline going. I recall one night we were coming back from the prison at Parwan. It was the middle of the night, pitch black, and so the next thing you know, a fireball is coming out underneath the helicopter and these flares are going out. So we had to land and we put down in a pretty bad area. I thought, well, this is where it's all going to happen. We're about to get attacked and, I might not end up going home. Obviously, luckily, that turned out fine. And then we took off and made it back to the FOB. So the experience in Afghanistan, I think, profoundly changed me forever. And I think it probably does with most people that serve over there. It certainly had an impact on me as a judge as well, because you have had a very difficult experience. You realize how long, I was in Afghanistan for 7 months, so you realize perhaps when you sentence somebody, how long the time you're giving them is, because how slow it goes. I've always had the thought pattern and the philosophy of life that you need to have an interesting life. I gave some advice to some high school students that I was speaking to recently, and I said, if there's something that you can do that's not going to hurt anybody else or be overly dangerous to yourself, and it will make you an interesting person, if it'll make a good story, then you should do it. You got to get out there and try stuff. Don't be timid. Think outside the box. Get outside your comfort zone. And trust me, you'll enjoy it, and it'll make a very fulfilling life, and it certainly has for me.